What's going on, Nasty Nation? It's Nasty, and in today's video, I'll be going over my in-depth guide to playing Karma in Season 10. Now, I understand that on YouTube right now, there's a lot of videos out there that will clickbait you into watching a video that you think is a guide when in reality it's not. This video is not one of those, though. This video is going to be an in-depth guide that goes over abilities, runes, builds, skill orders, matchups, combos, and many more things that'll help take your Karma to the next level. With all of that being said, be sure to leave a like on the video if you do go on to enjoy it or find it helpful. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and finally, make sure that you comment down below letting me know what champion you'd like to see me do a guide for next. That should just about do it for this introduction, so without further ado, let's get into the video. First things first, let's go over Karma's abilities. Karma's passive is Gathering Fire. Each time you attack an enemy champion, your ultimate ability will be reduced by 1 second. This ability only has half the effect when using basic attacks. This passive may not seem all too strong, but once I go over the rest of the abilities, you'll understand just how strong this ability can actually be. Now we're actually going to skip ahead a little bit here and go over Karma's ultimate ability next. This ability is called Mantra. Karma's ultimate ability is something that you'll get at level 1 in the game, and it's going to be on a very short cooldown for the entire game. Using this ability will make it so that your next ability is increasingly strong and has an additional effect. We'll go over those in just a second. Karma's Q is Inner Flame. Using this ability will send forth a ball of spirit energy that explodes and deals damage upon hitting an enemy unit. This is an AoE damaging ability, meaning that even if you miss the target that you're originally aiming for, if you hit something that's nearby, both targets will still be hit. Using Mantra on this ability will make it so that the ability does more damage, and it also creates a Cataclysm, which deals more damage after a short delay. This ability all by itself allows Karma to be such a strong lane bully in the lane phase and have a large presence in the early game. Karma's W is Focused Resolve. If you've ever played LeBlanc, this is kind of similar to her E, except rather than landing a skill shot, it's a point and click ability. Clicking W on an enemy will do a brief amount of damage while also connecting a tether to them. If you're able to stay within range of them and allow the tether to connect, they will be stunned for a short period of time. If you use Mantra on this ability, then the CC duration after the tether is finished will be longer, and you'll also get a heal when you connect the ability and when the ability finishes. This ability can be a little difficult to use because the tether range is not all that long, so you have to position pretty well in order to actually get this to connect. But the more you play Karma, the more familiar you'll be with this ability and the easier it'll be to finish. And finally, Karma's E is Inspire. This ability can be used on an ally or yourself to grant a small shield and a burst of movement speed. Using Mantra on this ability will grant the movement speed and the shield to all surrounding players. This ability is extremely useful for getting back to lane quicker, helping yourself speed up so that you can connect the tether, or using this on an ally to keep them alive, or even to proc Ardent Sensor late game. As for Karma's skill order, things are pretty simple. In every situation, you're going to want to put points in Q first, maxing that out, maxing E second, and maxing W last. W is not the most important ability on this champion because even though the CC is nice, you're not really picking Karma for her CC, you're picking her more for her poke and her enchanter abilities, which are from her Q and her E. Of course, this also includes putting a point in your ultimate ability whenever possible. As for my recommended rune page for Karma, I would recommend starting in the sorcery page with Summon Airy. This is followed by Nimbus Cloak, Absolute Focus, and Scorch. Summon Airy is going to give you the perfect combination of poke and also having larger shields, and again, because Karma's Q and E are her main abilities, this is just going to enhance both of those abilities and make you a lot stronger. Following that, I have Nimbus Cloak, and I think most people here are actually taking Mana Flow because it is pretty standard to take Mana Flow on Enchanter Champions. However, if you use Nimbus Cloak correctly, you're going to be a lot more impactful as Karma. What you can do with this rune is flash W onto the enemies, and because you're getting that burst of movement speed from your flash, even if the enemy flashes away too, you'll be fast enough to connect that tether. So you can essentially go flash for flash with the enemy and still connect your CC. Up next, I have Absolute Focus, and I think that Absolute Focus is the best choice here because Karma could be a really big lane bully, and this is just going to help you do a lot more damage and get a lead early game. Some people are taking Transcendence, which I can understand why people would think that, but again, Absolute Focus is going to help a lot with the early game. And finally, we have Scorch. This is just a no-brainer here. Again, it's just going to allow you to do more damage, which is something we really want to focus on when it comes to playing Karma because the lane phase is really important. As for the secondary tree, I would recommend running Inspiration with Biscuit Delivery and Cosmic Insight. Biscuit Delivery is going to increase your mana pool, and it's also going to give you some more sustain in the lane phase. This just allows you to be at full health and full mana for longer periods of time in the lane phase, allowing you to poke down your enemy even more. Cosmic Insight, I think, is just another really good choice here. Some extra CDR will always go a long way. And finally, to finish off the rune page, I would recommend running 2 Adaptive Force and 1 Armor. The armor is just for some defensive stats while trading, and the 2 Adaptive Force is going to make you do a lot more damage. As for some other iterations of this rune page, I think that if you find yourself in a losing matchup, it is okay to switch out the Inspiration tree for the Resolve tree. If you do this, I would recommend taking Revitalize and Bone Plating. Revitalize is going to make your shield stronger, and Bone Plating is just going to make you a little bit harder to kill when initiating these trades. And one final rune change change that I will mention is taking Arcane Comet over Summon Eri. This is something that I'll do every once in a while if I really believe in my ability to punish the lane and win lane super hard, because Comet is going to make it so that I do even more damage. Eri does allow some extra damage when trading, but it's not quite as much as Comet. So if you are looking to just completely bully the lane, I think Comet is good, but for the most part, I would recommend going Eri more times than not. As for Karma's build path, I would recommend starting the game with Spell Thieves as your starting item. I understand that there are some enchanter supports in the game that have the option to build Relic Shield and play a little bit more safe and passive, but you don't pick Karma to play passive. You pick Karma if you want to be a lane bully, and Spell Thieves is going to enable you to do more damage and be that lane bully. Following the support item, I would recommend picking up Lucidity Boots. CDR boots are really good on Karma, and honestly, I just don't think that there's too many boot options out there that are better than Lucidity Boots at the moment. I think that you can go Mobis on Karma if you want to roam around a lot more, but the thing is Karma is a really good team fighting champion, and Mobis, although is good for roaming around the map, in team fights is going to make it so that you're a lot slower, and you want to be mobile while in team fights as Karma. This is going to be even more important when trying to connect tethers. If you're slow, you won't be able to finish your tether and you won't be able to get that CC off. So having the extra mobility from Lucidity Boots over mobility boots in team fights is going to go a long way. Following that, I would recommend picking up Unholy Grail. I think that Unholy Grail is just the best item that you could possibly have on Karma. It's going to make it so that she does a little bit more damage, she's a little bit harder to kill, and also the passive that you're going to get from your shield is just going to go a long ways, and overall I can't see a much better item to go on Karma. However, there are going to be certain games in which the enemy team probably just doesn't have a whole lot of AP, or maybe they're full AD. In a situation like this, you don't have to build Unholy Grail, but 9 times out of 10, you should be building this item. If you do find yourself in a situation like that though, you can just skip this and continue on with the rest of the build. Following Unholy Grail, I would recommend picking up an Ardent Sensor. Late game teamfighting as Karma with Ardent Sensor is just extremely OP. Using your Mantra E in teamfights is going to apply Ardent Sensor to your entire team, and it's going to make it so that your entire team is a lot stronger for about a 5-second window. And then as long as you're playing the team fights correctly, auto attacking and using your Q on the enemies, you're going to be proccing your passive, getting your ultimate back up again. So you have the potential to get 2 Mantra E's off in the same team fight, getting Ardent Sensor off to all of your teammates. And overall, this item synergizes really well with Karma. So I would consider Spell Thieves, CDR Boots, Unholy Grail, and Ardent Sensor to be the core build on Karma. As long as you get these items, you should be in a good spot. After that, it doesn't really matter all too much what you're building as long as it's not super troll. Any enchanter support item can slot in for the 5th and 6th item pretty well. So it could be Shirela's, it could be Redemption, it could also be something like Locket or Crucible. Really at this point of the game, just try to analyze whatever your team needs most. If you need to engage or disengage easier, then Shirela's is a good option. If your team just is getting burst by Karthus or something like that, then you can opt for a Locket. If the enemy team has an Ash Arrow that you're worried about, you can build a Crucible. If you need to just be a stronger presence in team fights, you can get a Redemption. So overall, slot in any items here. There is no wrong answer as long as it's not super off meta and troll. Next up, let's go over the matchups for Karma. So some good matchups for Karma will consist of really immobile ADCs and really immobile supports. This is going to allow Karma to bully them really easily, land a lot of Qs on them, and overall just dominate the lane phase. This will include ADC champions like Jinx or Kog'Maw, or some support champions such as Nami or Xerath. As for some poor matchups for Karma, this is going to include mobile ADCs like Ezreal and Lucian, and it's also going to include support champions that have a lot of engage, such as Thresh or Blitzcrank. Mobile ADCs can easily get out of the way of Karma's poke and trade back, and support champions with a lot of heavy engage and CC can punish Karma for stepping forward and kill her very easily because she is a squishy champion. Next up, let's talk about some gameplay aspects of Karma, and this is going to include the early game and the lane phase. This is really crucial to Karma because if you aren't playing the lane phase correctly, you're not going to be able to snowball your lead, and that's something you desperately need to do on this champion. In the lane phase, your main goal is to try to get into the enemy team's face and trade with them as much as possible. This could include stepping to the side of the minion waves and trying to trade with Q and auto, also making sure that you're proccing E on yourself to shield yourself, grant some extra movement speed, and make it a little bit more difficult for them to trade back with you. And then eventually, once you're able to poke them down, you can always look for all-ins with W, but do be careful because if you're stepping too far forward without vision and you've already used your E, you'll die pretty easily in the lane phase. Overall, the lane phase is a rinse and repeat process of trying to step forward, poke the enemy down, and eventually look for all-ins as long as you have good vision or you know where the enemy jungler is. One really easy way that you can poke down the enemy with your Q in the lane phase is by aiming your Q at the caster minions when they're standing next to it. Even though your Q isn't going to hit the enemy, the splash radius from your Q is actually going to hit them, so you'll be able to get the damage off from an increased distance and they won't see it coming. That is my number one piece of advice when it comes to being a lane bully in the lane phase as Karma. Next up, let's talk a little bit about roaming as Karma. Again, this is something I mentioned earlier, is something Karma is definitely capable of doing, which is why mobility boots can synergize well on her. However, again, mobility boots are going to make her slower when in combat, and that's going to make it really hard to land your tether. But even without mobility boots, you still have the option to roam. My suggestion to you is that you try to come from the river or from behind the enemy. Try to speed yourself up to get as close to the enemy as possible. Maybe a Q from a further distance away to slow them if you're not close enough or ready to land a tether, and then connect the tether. When it comes to landing the tether, I would recommend that you don't Q, you don't auto attack, you don't do anything when the tether is trying to connect, other than try to follow the enemy and keep them as close to you as possible. If you're trying to auto attack or Q while your W is connecting, then it's going to essentially slow you down and allow them to get away. If you are extremely confident that your tether is going to connect no matter what, then of course it's going to be more efficient for you to auto attack and Q rather than just walking around trying to connect the tether. But again, if you are unsure if the enemy team has flash or mobility, or if there's any chance that they can get away, then just try to press W on the enemy, speed yourself up to keep as close to them as possible, and connect that tether. That's a piece of advice that I would recommend you take into all roams, but also something to keep in mind when trying to lock down an enemy at any stage of the game. And finally, the last thing that I want to talk about when it comes to playing Karma is team fighting and the late game. This is actually one of the most important things that I want you all to remember from this video, because this is the most common mistake that I see Karma players making. As you might have been able to tell throughout this entire video so far, I keep talking about how Karma is a lane bully, how she can poke down the enemy really easily, and this is all true. Early game, you definitely want to play Karma as if you're an AP mage. However, when it comes to late game, when it comes to team fighting, you have to flip that switch and convince yourself that you're no longer an AP mage poke support, and that you're actually now an enchanter support. Again, this is a problem that I see most every Karma support player making, because they don't know when to flip that switch. When it comes to team fighting, that is when it's time to flip that switch. The problem is most people continue to use Mantra Q to poke down their enemies even in late game, when Mantra E is going to be a lot more efficient. As I mentioned earlier when going over the build, Mantra E is going to apply a huge shield to your entire team, and it's also going to allow everybody to get Ardent Sensor, which is far more impactful than using Mantra on your Q or your W. There will still be times late game in which it's acceptable to use Mantra on other abilities. I think that if you are trying to finish off an enemy, Mantra Q is going to be really good because it's going to allow you to do more damage. If there's a large group of enemies all bunched together, then Mantra Q will be good because you're going to be getting a multi-man slow. If you are trying to lock down an enemy late game and you really need the CC duration to be as long as possible, or maybe you're low health and you need to heal up a little bit, then Mantra W will definitely still be useful. But overall, when it comes to late game and team fighting as Karma, Mantra E is going to be your bread and butter, and that's what's going to win you a lot of games. Be sure to flip that switch late game and be the enchanter support that your team needs you to be. Well, alright then, ladies and gentlemen, that should just about wrap up this in-depth guide to playing Karma in Season 10. Again, if you guys did go on to enjoy the video or find it helpful, then be sure to leave a like on the video and subscribe to the channel if you have not done so already. Also, drop a comment down below letting me know what champion you'd like to see me do a guide for next. Thank you guys so much for watching to the end of this video. I really appreciate it, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.